Okay, so what happens to Kamsky that's so bad? No, look over here! Look over here! Yeah. Yeah, that's what you want. Oh, crap. Oh, he just one-shot me. Shite. Okay, so what do? I gotta get his attention. And then I gotta, manage to stay away from him while he nails me to the floor? Of the ocean? Maybe I'm just supposed to keep him company while she sets charges. How the heck am I gonna do this? Get up, bitch. Oh, listen to this music. No, get away. Oh, this is gonna be insane! I'm gonna be very annoyed with this. Super fast. The most annoying part of this is gonna be how long the load is. Alright, come on, asshole. Okay, so he hits me a little bit, and then my first issue should be trying to nail him, get him to look at me, right? Oh my god. Oh, is he going after and I get him? Oh no, look at her. Don't look at her. Look at me. Yeah. Look at me. Dickhead. This requires me to aim, which is, as we all know, not my forte. Hurry up, Anna! I don't know if you know this, but I'm not good at this. Oh, crap. And he comes and kicks my shit, and then I die. Or I don't die. And I shoot him as hard as I can. And I hope that he doesn't kill me. And then it happens again. So I shoot him in the spine. And I hope that he pays attention to me and not her. And then how do we kill this guy? Where the fuck did he go? Don't go over there, dickhead. Oh my gosh. I need a gun that shoots. Come on, dick. Oh boy. Where is he? Do we do it? We don't kill him?
Anna!
Get to the chopper! This is all I've done is shield this. Oh, that looks nice. She shut the door on me! Ma'am? Oh wait, no, I'm gonna have to keep fighting. I can't do that. I thought we made it. I thought maybe it was one of those kind of like trick endings where it's like you don't actually have to do that much longer, but... No, it's 100% you have to kill this guy. After he like bites my head off. Oh fuck. Where are you searching corpses for ammo? Can you run please, dude? You're gonna make me dump on this guy? I will die. This is not gonna happen, man. I don't see any corpses either. You see corpses? Because I don't see nothing. That's a corpse over there. Yep, okay. So thanks for some ammo. This guy is just gonna kick my shit right in. That's what you want me to do? You want me to do that? That doesn't feel good though. It feels very not... Feels like he just slaps me around. I don't want to... No, see, he's just slap-tapping me. Okay, pick me up. Apparently, I guess I want you to do that. Are you picking me up or what? See, what I'm worried about is if I screw up this part, I have to do the other part again. I would love to. Anna, do you think you could throw a bazooka out the door there for me, sweetheart? How do I get him to grab me? How do I... And he just slaps me around. He doesn't pick... The only time he picked me up was that very first time. Okay, maybe if I get up close personal with him. Come here, guy. No, he doesn't want to pick me up. He just wants to slap me around. I don't know what to do. pick me up, please. It says you're gonna pick me up, and you haven't picked me up. Not at all. Okay, this doesn't work. I'm not sure what to do, but maybe if I jump on him, he'll pick me up. After I die? I sure hope that there's a corpse over here with a life pack that really feels good. Thanks for the ammo. What I really need is health. Because this game doesn't let me carry health with me, I'm completely at the mercy of what's around. There's two corpses, that's what's around. Okay. Huh? That didn't do anything! Okay. Alright, so even when he picks me up, didn't care. Alright, nailing it. All he does is throw me down. I'm not sure what he wants me to do. And I'm out of snipers. Okay. Dude, I've only got a smidge of life left. You might as well just show me the mechanic that I need to understand for next time. Get up. Try searching a corpse again. Maybe they refill. Get off me, sir! You're not gonna do the- Oh, hey, thanks for the ammo. Oh, get stuck, dude. I don't get it. That's why I'm annoyed. Once I get it. So I'm not- you might as well just fall off. Okay. Bye! Alright, do this ultra annoying part again. Come here, dickhead. Okay, I checked because I was like, what the hell am I doing wrong? I didn't see it on the screen, but when I hammer on the buttons, I need to also hit another button to shoot him. And like, you know, when we did the critical hits, it was like R1, but it would prompt us to do that with the critical hits, and I don't think I saw a prompt, but I think that's maybe what I'm supposed to do. So when he picks me up when we get to phase 2, I'll just hammer on R2 or R1, whatever the heck. Let's see if that does the trick. He gets a little bit more inclined to cooperize. Get off me, douche nozzle. Dickhead. I should get away from him. Ah! Do I ever like the final boss? I don't think I do. I think I'm always like, oh, why are you being different? Why are you making my life difficult? Ooh. Why are you being such a snooze? Why can't you just give me this? Dang, don't be so negative. I know. This one is just, this is a little weird. It's just, it's a smidge tricky. I mean, it doesn't seem to be a straight, like, it's not just dump it, which is different. I don't like different. I mean, I do. I reserve the right to bitch about it. Okay. That's great, Anna. Okay, what I need is ammo, though, honey. I'm trying to get a handle on this. Pick me up. Oh, it is there! It is there! I just didn't see it before. Okay. Alright, as usual, the problem is me. Never assume the problem's the game, thanks. It's always you. Alright, let me just pick my shit in a little bit. What I need him to do is pick me up. Just pick me up. How do I tease him into picking me up? That's what I really want to know. Is... okay, enough of the slappy dappies. Just come over here and pick me up, guy. Is there a way to stop him from doing that? Because I just want him to pick me up, and I'm not sure how to get him to do that. Fuck off, dude! Just pick me up, you fuck! Can you not be a shit? Wow, what I wouldn't give for a flippin' dodge right now, man. Try not to get sour! Pick me up! Okay, thank you. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba! Hate you. Okay, pick me up again. Just pick me up! Just pick me up! Shoot you in the face, we can all go home. Get up, dude. How many times do I have to? That's rule of three. That's Bowser rules. Do you play by? Yes, you play by Bowser rules. Thank you very much, sir. Please be done. Yes! And then I fly away like a hero on this flimsy Roplotter. Did we just beat Cold Fear? Nice.
It's all right. I'll take care
of it. I'll do it.
I'm sorry.
Goodbye, Papa.
Okay. Yeah. We're heroes. There was no way that was going to compete with Resident Evil 4 coming out at the same time. That's it, eh? Yeah, that was never going to beat them. Cool, for sure. I feel like you could have a lot of fun with this. So you can get this. This is the PS2 copy. But you can just get this on Steam. And if you're like a normal gamer, unlike Dane, you can just mouse and board it. Or you can, I would imagine there's some sort of something so that you can use a controller with it. But you could wander around here, do better than I did, let me know how it goes, because I did real bad. What kind of music is that, Manson? Use your fist and not your mouth! What does that mean, Manson? Does that mean don't use your words, just hit people? Because that's deep, sir. What's that song he's got where is We Know Where You Fucking Live? Or something like that? That was interesting. Man, this is old Manson. About the time that, like, I wasn't hanging on every single album because I was busy. You know, because you go through that period, right? Where all you care about is your artists and your inspirations and your idols, and then, like, you have bills to pay. That's pretty good, actually. I don't think I'll be adding it to my driving playlist, but it's pretty good. This was cool. I did like this. I love monsters on a boat at sea. I think it was a good choice to do the boat and then an oil rig. And I'm trying for the life of me to remember how Dead Aim goes. Resident Evil's Dead Aim. Because that's on a boat too. Resident Evil keeps happening on boats. But do we get off the boat? Because that's the problem with putting any game on a boat, is that the boat can only be so friggin' big, so you gotta get off of it. This one going onto an oil rig was actually, I think, very smart. And I would have loved to have seen more oil rig. I don't know what there is to see, but I could imagine some interesting things. More underwater type things would have been rad. I feel like this is the kind of game that... Okay, it didn't stick its landing commercially, right? But this is the kind of game that, like, if you were maybe to spend some time with it, especially in your formative years. And by formative years, I mean, like, when you're coming up with inspirations, that someone might play this and come up with something that they're this would be great as inspiration for something else, I think is what I'm trying to say. And you know what? As a fan of hating the ocean, I think we need more stuff that happens in the ocean. More credit sequences like this that are making me seasick. We need more thalassophobia. We need more submechanophobia. We need, like, a diving sequence where you get sucked into a pipe and you almost get eaten by a turbine. Like, we need that kind of stuff in our horror. And this would be a great sort of brain massager to get the juices flowing for something like that. I think this is good. I think this is one you should actually play. I mean, do whatever the hell you want, but this is cool. Do I own this on Steam? I have this tendency to buy things on Steam because Steam is so good at sticking sales in your face. And then going, I don't want to play it on the computer. I'm not part of the PC Master Race. And so then I just find the disc copy and play it on the console. Because I'm lame! I'm getting the impression that this was like a French company. By these names. Laurent Regal. English linguistic testing, bug tracker, English voices. Good job, Andy Chase. I don't know who any of you are. Are they just like France? There you go. Are they just looping it? Now I have to Google Gold Fear. Gold Fear, Cold Fear. Daughter money. They're like, look what we did with this boat. Do you see how it's rocking out? This was a marvel of its time. Oh, this is on Xbox too. Like OG Xbox. So yeah, PS2 and Xbox and Windows. So I don't know if you got an old Xbox hanging around, it's probably easier to get copies of the Xbox. Oh, look at this. April 2006, Variety reported that Avatar Films, don't know who they are, and Secretagant Productions had co-purchased the rights for a feature film adaptation of the game. However, there have since been no further developments. Which means that some guy is sitting on the IP doing nothing with it. That's one of the things I've never liked about the entertainment world, is that people come up with these great ideas, they write these fabulous scripts or these fabulous stories or, you know, whatever, and then they sell them, and then the person who gets them, they're not required to do anything with it. So it just sits in a drawer, and it's like, okay, but, you know, could you maybe, if you're not going to do anything with it in the next 20 years after that expires, can you be forced to put it back up for sale maybe? Dane, that's slippery slope. Well, there's got to be something, right? Because copyright expires after a certain amount of time after you're dead, right? You don't own what you made anymore, right? Like, that's why Cthulhu is in everything, because Howard Philip Lovecraft. Why did it take me a minute? Dude? You know why? It's because I have a character in a story named Howard Philip Glynn that is kind of Cthulhu era-esque, and that's the name. So I'm used to saying that name, not Lovecraft. Like, his estate, if there was one, doesn't have any rights to any of that crap anymore, because it's long since expired, because he's been dead that long. And it becomes, you know, public domain. Something like that should apply to crap like this. Right? And I don't think that it should be hinged on the death of... Because, like, who would you attribute this to? Like, look at all the names that have been listed. Who would you attribute this to? And if it's owned by a company, like the copyright, it's not owned by an individual. As far as I know, there's no expiration on that. And that kind of sucks, right? Like, really great example is Douglas Preston and Lincoln Child. These two authors. I love these guys. And I will read their garbage even once it's garbage. They wrote Relic. And if you saw Relic with Tom Sizemore, you're like, that sucked. Because that movie did suck. It was not that great. I saw it at a sleepover one time at a group home. I was not the kid at the group home, but group homes will do birthday parties for your friends who are in group homes. And it was bad. But I found that book when I was working this crappy call center job. Someone had left it behind, so I took it because it was at the station that I went to. And I started reading it, and I was hooked. And I read that thing all the way through. And the ending just, oh, gorgeous. Perfect. Love it. Went on to read Reliquary, it's actually the beginning of a whole sort of strung together series. They don't put digits on the books, but it's the Pendergast series, so to say, because it's Agent Aloysius Pendergast. And there's this whole beautiful IP that's right there, but it's gone because I'm pretty sure it's Paramount, owns it. And you'll never see them do anything with it. And they didn't even put the character that went on to actually carry them as authors, like when they team up together. It's not the only series they write, but it carried them all the way through, and nothing will ever be done with it because it's just sitting in a basement at Paramount somewhere where they're like, oh, we tried, we cut out the main thing and we put Tom Sizemore in there. No offense to Tom Sizemore, but you know what I mean? We made a shitty movie and now, well, it's nothing there, never do anything with it, go screw yourself. I think that shit should expire at some point. You make it 100 years, whatever. I just think it should expire because I don't know, I feel like art and ideas, like the same way, I'm going on a tangent here, the same way that, you know, artists will be like, I don't want that person to listen, remember when Eminem was like, I don't want them to listen to my music because they like Trump or whatever, well, it's not yours anymore, in that sense. You release art out in the world and it belongs to the people that receive it. So, like, don't leave it in a basement at parent. Okay, whatever. I'm fucking out of here. That was Cold Fear. Thanks for joining me.